Welcome to the Simple Sophisticate Podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. I'm your host, Shannon Abels. And whether you're listening on your commute, exercising, working in the garden, or sitting down with a hot cup of tea or a cafe au lait, thank you for tuning in. Let's get started. Welcome to the 271st episode of The Simple Sophisticate. Today is the last new episode of 2019, and I'm going to end it with, I'm going to end this year for a new episode with a discussion about simple winter holiday decor ideas. Now, this is going to be inspired from wrapping my head around how I really want to decorate and some of the ideas I've incorporated into my home. And I started to search through my blog's archives thinking I had posted this type of thing before, this kind of focus, and evidently I have not. Probably because I really didn't know how I really wanted to decorate, and I'm still learning. But I have a better sense of what the holidays, for me, I want them to be and what I want them to feel like. So today we're going to talk about, or I'm going to share, 12 simple winter holiday decor ideas. But before I do, this week's petit plaisir is a recipe that I've tweaked a bit, but it was one that I shared, oh my gosh, 8 years ago on the blog. And I'll just say this, it involves chocolate and is oh so simple and oh so decadent. You will have fans for years if you make this for your household, your friends, your colleagues, your neighbors, whomever you choose to cook it for or bake it for. But before I get to today's episode, I want to share one last thing. So next Monday, the 23rd, I will have a short episode to announce the top 5 episodes of 2019 here on the podcast and then link to each of those on the blog. So if you're curious as to what the top 5 were, be sure to tune in next Monday, the 23rd. And then a brand new episode is going to come to you on Monday, January 6th, 2020. I had originally thought about posting a new episode on the 1st of January, but the more I started to reassess and really find the right pace of my life, I'm going to be away on holiday at that point. And I said, you know, I always love to write. No matter where I am, I can write. I can't take my studio with me always for quality taping. So this is what I'm going to promise to you, the listeners. If you are looking for New Year inspiration, stop by the blog on January 1st, 2020, and you will certainly find inspiration, a brand new post. But I'm going to save the first new episode of the year for our traditional Monday meeting, if that's all right with you. I am excited for 2020, and I'm also excited to wrap up 2019 very, very well. So let's get into today's topic. As I shared at the top of this episode, upon moving into my new home, I wanted to properly decorate my house. What I mean by properly is I didn't just want to go through the motions. Not that I really ever went through the motions intentionally before, but as you'll see or hear as I share different ideas in today's episode, there were a lot of just details I thought I had to have. Now, my decor is very simple, and I don't want to become overwhelmed or stressed when I decorate, but I do love the winter holidays. And I love having that touch of something special to wrap the year up with. So as you may have been noticing over the last few weeks on Instagram and here on the blog a bit, I have slowly but surely been decorating for these winter holidays with a little bit on this weekend, a little bit on that weekend. And it all culminated this last weekend with the hunt for the tree. And I have shared a handful of those pictures from the tree hunt, as well as all the decorations and ideas I'm going to talk about on today's episode on the show notes, the simplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast271. So let's dive right in to the simple decor ideas. Number one, speaking of the tree hunt, depending upon where you live, understandably, I used to go buy a nice big tree, not necessarily big, but nice and full at a tree farm or a shop that would import trees from somewhere that farmed Christmas trees in the Pacific Northwest. They were between $50 to $70, which was definitely at the top end of my budget. Well, the last 2 years, this year being the second, I said, why am I not going right out of the forest in my backyard and cutting down my own tree? That's all we would do in my childhood. Every single year, we would get our Christmas tree permit, which is $5, very inexpensive. I don't think that price has changed my entire life. And then you go hunting for your tree. There are certain rules as to where you can hunt them and how tall they can be. I don't think they can be over 15 feet. And I think they have to be 150 feet from the road, a traditional road for traffic, not a trail road. And that's about it. So this year I did that again. And not only are you saving your budget, but you're also helping the forest because you're actually keeping the forest healthier. Here in the Pacific Northwest, a lot of people go out and hunt for their trees. You'll see them coming off the mountain with a tree on the top of their car. And it's a lot of fun too. I obviously will take my dogs. And the last year I went with a friend. This year I went by myself. And it was just a lot of adventurous fun. And I was really glad I waited till this last weekend for a couple reasons. Number one, there was snow in the mountains this weekend, which made it extra special. But then I started to realize that having a tree halfway through the holiday season makes it all the more special when it arrives, and that beautiful, fresh forest scent, so in this case, pine, fills the house through the new year. It doesn't dry out too soon. And I like that. So that's number one, save money. And if you can, go into the forest and hunt for your tree in national, state, or county lands. Now, I've included a link for the Deschutes County Forest and their ideas and inspiration and why they say this is healthy for the forest to do this. So if you're curious about that, check out the show notes. Now, if you're wondering about all the pictures for my tree hunting expedition, stop by the blog this Wednesday, the 18th, and I'll share with you all the pictures and tell you a few stories too. Norman and I had a great time, and it was Norman's first outing since his surgery. It wasn't that far, don't worry, but it certainly was a joy to have him with me. Oscar took a nap and waited for us, but he was totally fine letting us go hunting without him. So that's number one, save money and pay for a permit to go hunt your tree. Number two, elevate the tree. So when you bring the tree home this year, I have chosen to elevate my tree. And as someone who loves a tree, all the light to illuminate the house during the short days of December, I also realized how many decorations are needed to decorate a large tree. And admittedly, getting down on my hands and knees to water the tree every day wasn't always easy because I would always disturb some of the decorations or pour water onto the tree skirt. And it just wasn't that convenient. Now, I realize that not everyone has the certain ceiling that allows them to still have a very tall tree and put it on a table. Maybe get a small tree. I've done that before, as you can see from some of the links I've provided from previous trees. But what I love now about my house, and part of the reason I purchased this particular house, is that I didn't want a big house. Not that I could have afforded a big house anyway, but I did want a small house. I just needed high ceilings. And so in my house, I fortunately have vaulted ceilings. And so I can bring a tree in that's 5.5 feet this year, place it on a pub table, and it looks really tall, but it's not. And it's in proportion to the house. So it's fantastic. And it resolves both those issues with regards to having not enough ornaments or not enough lights, and also not having to bend down and water the tree. It's all at my level and it's perfect. So I provide a picture of that so you can kind of take a look at it in my house. I have gone really, really small with a tree a couple years ago. There's a picture of that on the show notes, or a link to that in the show notes. I've gone a lot taller. But what I find is I have just the right amount of ornaments for this type of a tree, and it keeps it out of the reach of pets. Not that my dogs at their age bother the tree too much, but Norman, when he was younger, he was curious and he wouldn't pull things down, but he would get his nose in there and sniff around, and just to protect the tree, it does help with that. And if you do have children, young children, this is also a way to avoid anything falling or being pulled off or anything at all. So just an idea that works for me. So that's number two, elevate the tree. Number three, make natural ornaments. Now, simple is best when it looks as though it belongs, naturally so. So when it comes to tree decorating, why not put pine cones right back on the tree? They look natural there. So it also could be a string of popcorn, dried oranges. But this year I said, you know, I'm going to add something different, a new texture, a larger ornament, but at the same time, nothing expensive. So I went out to my yard. I have one big tall pine tree and it gives me pine cones every other week or so, a bucket of them. And so I went out and picked up some pine cones and I took them inside and put them in a basket, put them in front of the fireplace for about an afternoon or morning, and they dried out. And then I chose a ribbon and I purchased some jute string and I hot glued a ribbon and the jute string, and I have brand new decorations this year. I was so excited about that. I provided some pictures of that on the blog, but the idea is simple, and I saw my mom do it many different times with different ornaments over the years. I've never done it myself. I am not a crafty person, but it really added a nice natural touch, plus the color that I wanted to bring into my holiday decor very simply and subtly. So all you need are pine cones, your choice of ribbon, jute string, and a hot glue gun. So simple. I think I had it done in 30 minutes and I made about 15 or 20 of these. That is number three. Number four is to hang decorations which hold memories of love, celebration, and your journey. As you may have noticed from my previous trees over the years, if you've followed along over the past couple years, I primarily would hang glittery ribbon, gold and white, and shiny stars and delicate holiday balls that were also of the color that I wanted. However, each year I had personalized ornaments from my childhood and handmade ornaments from my maternal grandmother that I typically would not hang, but I didn't want to get rid of them because I didn't know how I wanted to use them. Of course I wouldn't get rid of them. They're memories. They're my past. Sometimes though, I think it just takes time, takes each of us time to understand or know how to decorate in such a way that truly fits who we are. I don't begrudge how I used to decorate with regards to the glittery ribbon and the shiny stars that I just picked up at a craft store. I mean, I had fun exploring and trying new ideas that would catch my eye. And perhaps in the future, my preferences will change again. However, this year and for the foreseeable future, I want my tree to make me feel good or make the house feel good. So that's priority number one. And then second to that is that if it looks good, that's awesome too. Previously, I think I was going the other route and I thought by making it look beautiful, it would make me feel good. But I guess maybe it's just part of our life's journey. We get to a point where we want something different. So this year I have hung the handmade pine cone ornaments I just spoke about that symbolize the home I have the opportunity to call my own, and ornaments that were handmade by my grandmother, and ornaments from my childhood given to me each year by my parents and given to me by my grandparents, as well as now one new ornament from the life journey given to myself each year. This year it is, for the new ornament that I'm adding, a copper teapot. Now that was brought to my attention by Simply Luxurious Life reader Molly. I want to thank Molly for bringing that to my attention because I love it and it's on my tree right now. And when I bring all those little details together, it may not be perfect for anyone else and it may not make sense to anybody else, but it certainly adds a signature touch and makes me smile each time I see it throughout the day. So that's number four. Hang decorations which hold memories of love, celebration, and your journey. And you can find some pictures of all those decorations on the show notes and see the entire tree on Wednesday. Number five, selectively or elect not to have a tree topper. Okay, here we go. Similar to my journey in decorating, which I just shared, often my tree topper would also be somewhat generic, a generic star of some sort that I would pick up at a local craft store to match the other generic details that adorn the tree. Now, I say generic, but what I mean by that is to me, they didn't have a lot of story. There wasn't nostalgia there, and it may have looked okay, but it just never sat right with me. However, after much thought this year, I elected to not have a tree topper and decided to donate my old ones. And instead, I do have a picture of this on the blog, the show notes, and on the very highest branch, I placed a papillon, or a butterfly ornament, which speaks to the name I have given my home, which symbolizes something meaningful specifically to me and the journey that I am on. Now, again, your choice to top or not top your tree, and if so, with what, will be unique to you, so that each time you look up, you too will smile and are either inspired, comforted about the life you have lived, have the opportunity to live, and hope to live moving forward. So again, just adding those special signature touches to your tree. Number 6, utilize small copper or metal baking dishes as candle holders that are placed throughout the home. Now, I was recently inspired by a fellow recipient of Sharon Santoni's My Stylish French Box when I saw in a picture she shared that she used her cannelli molds, which I received in the first French cuisine theme box that Sharon sent out, I think 2 years ago. She gave each recipient 3 cannelli molds. By the way, she's also giving this themed box the second time this coming February. She doesn't do this all the time. This is only the second time in the 19 boxes she's given out. And it's a fantastic box to choose if you haven't done so already. I have a link to the box and all the information about it on the blog, the show notes, if you're interested. But I don't make cannellis that often. Admittedly, I haven't made any at all ever, but I want to. And so these molds were just sitting in my cupboard, not being used. And so I said, I'm going to use them this year. And you'll see them in a picture that I put on the blog. But I just put a tiny tea candle votive in each of them. The tea votive is encased in its own packaging, or so to speak, a plastic holder, so that wax won't go all over the molds. Don't have to worry about that. So you can still use them for baking. And they just add that little something special. They're simple though, and they have multi-purposes now. Granted, these molds can be very expensive if you buy them brand new. And so another idea, which is something I also have and I'm using, are the metal silver-colored brioche roll molds. And these you can buy at 1 or 2 for $9 or $10 at Sur La Table. And I link to those on the show notes. But these two are great little tulip edged silver mold. And it's just a simple, unique touch to add a little character to the votives you want to put around your house. And it's also a safe place to put your candle. Anyway, so just some ideas there. And I always stock up on tea lights. I always have a bunch in my house just for any occasion. And you can purchase 50 of them for $7 at World Market. But wherever you find them, just bulk up, always having those on hand. They just add a little something special to any kind of event or mood or time of day. That is number 6. Now, I have a sponsor I'd like to introduce you to before I get to the remaining 6 of the list for simple holiday decor ideas. If there is something that is interfering with your happiness or preventing you from achieving your goals, or if you simply just want to start the new year with the tools you feel you don't have, but you know if you had them, you can make the next year great, BetterHelp is online counseling that is there for you. Connect with your professional counselor in a safe and private online environment, and it's also extremely convenient. Now you can get help on your own time and at your own pace. You can schedule secure video or phone sessions, plus chat and text with your therapist. Licensed professional counselors are specialized in anger, grief, self-esteem, stress, anxiety, relationships. So be sure to check them out, as you can find someone to specialize in what you're looking for. Anything you share is confidential, and if you're not happy with your counselor for any reason, you can request a new one at any time for no additional charge. BetterHelp is available worldwide, and you can start communicating in under 24 hours. Financial aid is also available for those who qualify, but best of all, it's a truly affordable option for all Simple Sophisticate listeners. You have the opportunity to take 10% off your first month with the discount code SIMPLE. So why not get started today? Go to betterhelp.com/simple. Simply fill out a questionnaire to help them assess your needs and get matched with a counselor you'll love. That's betterhelp.com/simple. Use the promo code SIMPLE to save 10% off your first month. Now, as we get back to the list for 12 simple winter holiday decor ideas, the key here with any kind of holiday decorating is to make it enjoyable. Make it something that you look forward to, that doesn't have to be perfect, that is more of an experience than, I guess it's really an analogy for life. You enjoy the doing of it as much as the final outcome. So enjoy the journey as well as the destination. So let's get back into this list. Number 7. Use the trimmed boughs from the tree as decor that you will place around the home. Now, inevitably, if you are out tree hunting, even if you do buy a tree at a tree farm, you're likely to trim and just touch up so it fits the particular space you're putting your tree a little bit. Keep those boughs and turn them into maybe it's going to be the backdrop. So underneath a display of candles. Currently, I have a handful of the boughs with my Canelli mold candles sitting on top of it with a couple of big pomegranates. So I have a little bit of green, some candle and copper, and the red from the pomegranate. I didn't tie any bows on it. I just set them down as backdrop. And you know, they're going to dry out here probably in a week or two, but at least for a week, they smell amazing. So it's just something that adds that extra touch of the outdoors. Number 8, choose green, your preferred shade of green, as your accent color instead of red. Now, granted, each of us will have a preferred color we want to adorn our homes with to signify and celebrate the winter holiday season. For me, a soft sage green is my preference. However, if you love red, go for red. The key here, though, is to not feel you have to decorate with red and green. You don't have to be traditional. You can decorate however you want. If you want all white, go for all white. If you want ivory, go for ivory. If you love retro electric blue, go for that. What I loved about the color green is that it allows me to decorate for the Christmas holiday that I enjoy celebrating, but also to ring in the new year because I am in my home the last week of December. And when I take down the decorations, the house just feels different. And I often keep some of the decorations up through the new year. But if I take them down, it's because they just aren't inspiring me. So I wanted to choose a color that was comforting, inspiring, and didn't feel as though I was worn out from the holiday season. Green's a pretty perennial color that works year round, and it works with my decor, my aesthetic. I've never been someone who likes big, bright, bold colors, and so this color is subtle enough for my taste. But again, choose a color that you love and have some fun with it. As you'll see in the show notes, my green came in the form of the ribbons for my pine cones and on a few of the other ribbons that I chose for other decor around the home. Doesn't mean you can't have red. I have pops of red there too, but it's just something that I'm going to keep focusing on as I move forward in my decor from the holidays. Number 9, make your own unique garland. Mix the faux garlands. There's some fantastic garlands out there nowadays with fresh. Twist them up into one large garland, which is what I did for my mantle. Add small white garland lights and replace the fresh boughs as needed when they dry out with new ones. As well, you could add dried herbs you've kept from your garden to add a delicious scent throughout the home, or even add John's wort or eucalyptus plants, the little branches, to add a unique and different texture to the garland wherever you've placed it. I recently added a few of the boughs that I cut off my Christmas tree this last weekend and freshened up the garland above my fireplace because a few of the boughs had already dried out because they've been up for, I think, 2 weeks now. And it just added a whole nother oomph to the garland. So have some fun with your garland. Doesn't have to be fancy. You just start poking it in there. Be your own florist. And it's always a lot of fun. Number 10 is hygge it up. Spelt H-Y-G-G-E if you're wondering what I'm pronouncing. That is how you pronounce it, hygge. And what I mean by this is, in this case, for the holidays, candles, candles, and more candles. A home illuminated with candles and not because of a power outage is a beautiful, welcoming, and calming place to be. Don't be afraid to keep one or two electric table lamps on as well. If all candles may be too overwhelming for you, that's understandable. But having enjoyed an evening just recently over this past weekend, when the afternoon began to drift into evening and daylight started to disappear, I lit tea candles around the house as well as turned the tree on, and the house just felt as though it was giving me one big hug. I also had Charlie Brown's Christmas soundtrack on, so I just festified and holified it all up. I was in complete, complete bliss. So a simple thing to do is just bring more candles in. Just make sure you're, you know, lighting them and placing them somewhere safe and don't forget to blow them out. But there is something just so cozy about candles. So number 10 is hygge it up. Oh, and if you're wondering about what the Huga phenomenon is all about, in episode 148, I broke it all down and also talked about it as it aligns in so many different ways with living simply luxuriously. So that is episode 148. Number 11 is a simple idea to keep in mind if you are someone who likes to put holiday lights up outside. Now, I have white bulb lights that I put up in the summertime for evening or nighttime dining on my porch. I've never been one to put outdoor lights up for the holidays, partly because the houses I've been in are just either too difficult or it just wasn't something I wanted to do. But this year I put a few up, actually just one strand, but I didn't go out and buy new lights. I just used the white bulb lights that I had from the summer. And they worked great. Something very simple, something that worked for my house, and it didn't require me going out and buying new lights. And it just makes sure that the lights get double duty. They get their workout, so to speak. It just tells your neighborhood, yep, we're celebrating the holidays here in our own way and very simply, but we certainly love this time of year. So that's number 11. Number 12, last but not least, is to reduce, reorganize, and donate holiday decor for simpler decorating next year. Now, I shared this last week in the Simply Luxurious Life's weekly newsletter, the letter from the editor, that last week I took the time to go through all of my winter holiday decor. The result was one fewer boxes of stuff, and I donated all of this decor that was still in great condition that I just no longer used to a local donation center, and it freed up storage space as well as, with the help of clearly labeling what I had, putting all my tree decorations in one box, all my other home decor for the holidays in another box, clearly labeling it, making sure everything that would eventually be taken down had its own box. It's just going to make, for me and my peace of mind, every subsequent year's decorating process so much easier and smoother. And since I know how I want to decorate now, I can keep my eyes open throughout the year, but also know that what I have is just enough as well. So that's number 12, reduce, reorganize, and donate holiday decor for simpler decorating next year. Now, the concept or idea of decorating simply will differ depending upon how you have decorated in previous years and what brings you comfort when the holidays roll around, as well as joy. As we become ever more thoughtful about how and why we decorate the way we do, the winter holiday season will become infused even more deeply with appreciation and deep, true contentment as we celebrate and gather with those we love. I want to wish you the happiest of holidays and Merry Christmas and Happy Hanukkah and best wishes for the upcoming new year. Thank you so much for tuning in to this week's episode. I've included a couple of other holiday posts that are a similar topic to today's, such as there's a beautiful post, a decor post that shows an English Christmas drawing room and their take on a holiday tree. I've also shared an episode from a couple years ago, 2017, episode 184, where I share 16 ways to simplify and make the holiday season pleasurable, and then a list of 12 simply luxurious holiday films to enjoy each year. If you're interested, more festive posts and episodes are available to listen to or read on the show notes at simplyluxuriouslife.com/podcast271. And I'll be right back with this week's Petit Plaisir. This week's Petit Plaisir is an oldie but a goodie that's never been a Petit Plaisir, but it's the go-to cookie I make every holiday season for my neighbors, for my colleagues, and for myself. They are so good, and they involve a lot of chocolate. They are simply called quadruple chocolate cookies with all the chips, and they could not be easier to make. You're involving semi-sweet chocolate chips, white chocolate chips, bittersweet chocolate chips, and cocoa powder, all high quality. You mix it together with basic other ingredients. And I actually started to add, I tweaked the recipe a little bit this year, and I'm so glad I did. It just adds a little bit of extra texture. I added roasted almond slices. These cookies have now become basically like a Reese's peanut butter cup, but with crunch. And then you have the decadent chocolate. Oh, my goodness. I included a link to this recipe on my Saturday Ponderings post that just went up this last Saturday. You can find the entire recipe on the show notes. Just click on through, but I can guarantee you that these cookies will definitely be a hit, whether you're leaving them out for Santa, giving them to your family and friends, or simply sitting down for a nice leisurely evening with a hot cup of tea or a hot cup of coffee or whatever you like to sip and nibbling on these chocolates. I hope you've enjoyed this week's Petit Plaisir, where each week ideas are shared to make the everyday all the more enjoyable. Tune in at the end of each episode where I'll recommend a book, a film, a show, a recipe, anything that is a simple pleasure to satiate your sophisticated taste. Now, these cookies came out of a cookbook called Deep Dark Chocolate, Decadent Recipes for the Serious Chocolate Lover, written by Sarah Perry, and it came out in 2011, 2010. I found it when I was flipping through or reading The Oregonian in their Food Day section, which is one of my favorite sections of their newspaper, and I provide a link on the recipe page to that cookbook. If that is just speaking to you and you are a chocolate lover like myself, that might be a great book to add to your cookbook library. I want to thank you for tuning in on this last new episode of 2019. Tune in on Monday, January 6th for the first new episode of 2020, and tune in next Monday to discover what the top five episodes were of the Simple Sophisticate podcast in 2019. Wishing you and yours a very, very happy holidays. Thank you for tuning in to the Simple Sophisticate podcast, where intelligent living is paired with signature style. For more ideas and inspiration throughout the week, visit the blog, thesimplyluxuriouslife.com, or pick up my latest book, Living the Simply Luxurious Life, Making Your Everydays Extraordinary and Discovering Your Best Self, now available on Audible and wherever audiobooks are sold, as well as in paperback and ebook versions. You can also pick up my first book, Choosing the Simply Luxurious Life, A Modern Woman's Guide, which is also available in paperback, ebook, and as an audiobook as well. To stay caught up on the most recent episodes of the podcast, blog post, the cooking show, and receive exclusive news as well as an extra dose of inspiration to jumpstart your weekend, subscribe to the Simply Luxurious Life's free weekly newsletter, which arrives in your inbox each Friday to enjoy with a hot cup of tea or cup of morning coffee. Until next Monday, I'm your host, Shannon Abels. Bonjourne!